guys, my name is Indraja and welcome to another episode of Liberating Sexuality. In today's episode, we shall be unboxing the hymen myth. And it comes in this giant box labeled patriarchy. Now, the issue only appears to be this big, so don't get intimidated. The actual thing is right here, and the rest of it is just crap. I know, this thing is blown way out of proportion. So as you can see here, our hymen myth comes wrapped in many layers of packaging. We have one for religion, one for misinformation. My God, who did this? One for slut shaming. And finally, we get to our product. So this box is labeled virginity and it's wrapped in red paper. Red being the color of the blood that is supposed to violently spew out of you the first time you had sex. But don't worry, that's only to scare the fuck out of you, because only about 60% of women bleed the first time they have sex. Along with your red box labeled virginity, you also get a helpful instruction manual. So let's just take a look at this. It says, list of forbidden items that can damage your virginity. This includes, but is not limited to, sex toys, phallic vegetables, fingers, tampons, horse riding, swimming, dandia, cycling, gymnastics, climbing trees, masturbating, going to prom, playing Quidditch, wearing jeans, and eating chow mein. The last item on the list is not exactly an item on the list. It's a picture of Milind Soman with a giant X across it, because I mean, who wants to take their chances with that? So now it's time to open this box and see what's inside it. The first thing that I see here are flowers. I think they're meant to represent a girl's purity, and someone told me that they wither and die the second this box is opened. They look pretty alive to me, honestly speaking, but I guess we're just gonna toss them out anyway because they're of no use to this product. In this box, you will also find a white napkin. I think this is meant to, you know, test whether your goods are fresh. I've been told that it's used to judge a woman's character on the wedding night and decide whether or not you want to throw her away. So thank you for this napkin. So now we get to the most crucial item in this box, that is this tube, that is the vagina, and the fabric covering it, that is the hymen. If you look closely, you will notice that the hymen partially covers the opening of the vagina and doesn't block it completely. This is because during puberty, the hymen separates in order to allow the woman's body to have a menstrual flow. If her vaginal opening was blocked completely, she would not be able to have a period and would require medical intervention to fix it. Some hymens cover more of the opening and some hymens cover much lesser, and some women just have no hymens at all. Now, if I try to penetrate this hypothetical vagina with a hypothetical penis, which is my fingers, you will notice that it does not pop or tear or rupture, it simply stretches. That's what the hymen is supposed to do. It's supposed to stretch to accommodate whatever it is that you put inside. It is a very elastic tissue that remains a part of a woman's vagina for her whole life. It's not something that's going to vanish. Along with this, there's one more crucial item that I missed, and it's a bottle of lube. Now, I was really hoping I could use some, so this is pretty welcome. It's empty. I guess we'll just have to do without it, like most women the first time they have sex. So, while the vagina does lubricate itself when the woman is aroused, this is often insufficient to reduce the friction that takes place during sex. This friction can cause lacerations and bleeding, specifically the first time. However, not all women experience this bleeding, nor do they have to experience this bleeding. The hymen is by no means a seal that can determine a girl's virginity. Sex for the first time does not have to be a painful and scary experience. Some bleeding is possible, although it is by no means necessary that you will bleed. Using lubrication can reduce pain and discomfort during sex, whether it's the first time you do it or the 10,000th. Being emotionally and mentally prepared is extremely important, as is good communication with your partner. And please remember that whether or not you bleed or whether or not you bled in the past, everything is fine and you are perfectly normal. These so-called virginity tests are extremely unreliable and unscientific. The obsession with this archaic concept gets really dark when you consider that India still uses the two-finger test in instances of sexual assault. This test is used to determine whether a victim of sexual assault is habituated to sexual intercourse by observing her vaginal laxity and the presence of a hymen. If she happens to be habituated to sexual intercourse, she is often labeled a loose woman and blamed for what happened to her. For the last time, a woman's worth does not reside in her hymen. And if you think you can find out whether or not she has had sex before, you're wrong. What's that I hear? The sound of patriarchal delusions shattering in the distance? That's music to my ears. Hi guys, thank you so much for watching that video and I really hope you liked it. Do share this video if you think that virginity is a concept that needs to be done away with. And if you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them down in the comments because they're always welcome. And please subscribe because I do upload new videos every week. And until next time.